Okay, thank you everyone. Thank you for your participation to this presentation. Here actually we would show our work done in the ONAP Beijing release, where actually we have three, you know, authors for this presentation. It's regretted, you know, they cannot, the other two presenters cannot be here for visa reason. So here I would like to thank you for their contribution to this work, and I will deliver this presentation alone, but just bring all of your questions to me, and I'm sure can get you back and you know, explain everything to you. Okay, let us start. This is the agenda. Firstly, I would like to introduce a little bit about what's ONAP and the basic ideas and the most important concepts in ONAP community. And then I will give a use case about based on WOT and WayFarewall, such kind of thing, how to do the deployment and the distributed, you know, operation in ONAP. And the third thing is about our primary topic is how to do the closed loop resilience and how we improve that. And the result, the basic data performance improvement, something like that. And I would like to show a short demo based on our WayFarewall work. You can see how everything works and how all these things put together. Lastly, of course, a Q&A. Okay, firstly, I would like to say, you know, ONAP is a huge community today under Linux Network Foundation. And it comes from the marriage of the ECOMP and OpenO. Actually, ECOMP is come from, you know, AT&T, already deployed in AT&T at least 2 years, and it is good at the design automation and the closed loop resilience things. OpenO is another open community driven by China Mobile primary. OpenO is good at the standard template, you know, driven automation validation and virtual function onboarding things. So now we already have more than 17 Pretium members joined, and all the major operators already participate into this community, such as AT&T, China Mobile, Verizon, Vodafone, all these, you know, very famous operators. That means we already have more than 15 total mobile subscribers in the world, you know, in this community. So it's very long, you know, line for VMware to contribute to this community. Since early 2016, VMware already joined OpenO as a platinum, you know, members. And after that, we start working on Mercury release, a second release of OpenO. And on the 2017, actually the February, two community merged into ONAP under Linux Foundation. And VMware over there already work as a platinum, you know, founding members. And on the April, we delivered the Mercury release. And in the past November, we published Amsterdam release. That's the first release of ONAP. And in the next month, early next month, we will publish the next release, Beijing, for ONAP. So that's basically VMware's participation to the community. Then what's ONAP? ONAP is a realized end-to-end orchestration. That's different from the, you know, common NFVO things. But end-to-end orchestration put emphasis on the zero-touch, you know, provisioning. That means from the very beginning, the model design, and then do the instantiation, and do the operation, and the full AppCaps management. All these things are zero-touch. So that's what ONAP targeted to resolve. Just as this graph shows, from the beginning, you can see you will use model design to put the virtual functions together into end-to-end network service. And then you will put a button to deploy everything, you know, as an instantiation process to deploy your network service. And then you can enable the control flow, that's totally automatically, to understand what happened to your network service and then recover it if anything happened. And FCAPS is always very important and goes in parallel. ONAP can collaborate everything together automatically and collaborate seamlessly with the existing system, such as OSS, BSS, and EMS. That's very important for ONAP world, right? So that's more details about ONAP model design. You can see the first one, you know, the first column actually represents the packages from the virtual function vendors. The packages can be treated as a set of files, including the descriptors of the virtual functions and all the artifacts with that, such as the images and the requirements to the resources, all these things. And then we can, after onboarding, you know, upload all the packages to the SDC, that's the ONAP console, where you can put and drag different virtual functions into virtual, you know, network service. After that, you can see, okay, all the virtual link or virtual network connections has been built, and then you can distribute it. Before that, you may want to test and validate it and distribute it to the real, you know, deployment environment. So that's the whole automation loop introduced by ONAP. And then, you know, after we design how to do the service deployment, after distribution, actually the operator will see a catalog of network services in ONAP at runtime. And the operator can just click a button on any service you want to instantiate and trigger the automation loop to instantiate all the service underlying. What happened underlying? Actually, ONAP will pass all the descriptors you just use to mention all your resources and the network connections, virtual links, all these things. And then, you know, put it to the orchestrator and enable the VNFM to do the deployment. And the VNFM will call MultiMIM. That means a new module actually we introduced into ONAP where, you know, I'm the PTL of this project. And we have members from AT&T, China Mobile, and Intel, and VMware, and Microsoft. We build this project trying to provide a mediation layer that a different network service can enjoy any kind of backend cloud. And through MultiMIM, they can deploy the whole service and trigger the monitoring and information collection at a VIM layer. That's a VIM represents the virtual infrastructure manager. That's a basic function from the telco world. So that's just like the right size shows, you can use EMS and our virtual realized technologies to monitor all the workloads from different layers. And then, you know, after that, you can trigger the FCAPS monitoring. The most important thing of this graph is you can see, okay, we have different modules. That's EMS is a super legacy of the now telco world. And we have FVI to talk with the different, you know, OpenStack or Kubernetes or any kind of cloud backend. But from different layer, we will collect all these informations, such as EMS, we will collect information about you, what your network functions. But VIM layer will collect the, you know, information about your VM, your connector, your hardware, right? All these things. We will correlate them together into one DB of the ONAP and show all the things together on the portal. So that's FCAP's comparable work. So let us see what's the architecture of the ONAP. How, you know, what's the, how for ONAP to realize this goal? You can see from the app layer, and the ONAP will, just as I mentioned, will integrate with legacy service management system, such as OSS and BSS. That's very important in nowadays telco world. And then underlying, actually, we provide a portal, and there are two phases. One is a design phase. The other is a runtime. At the design phase, actually, as I just mentioned in the previous slides, where you will onboarding all your packages and drag and ship into all the network services at, you know, design time. After distribution, actually, the whole phase will jump from the runtime design time to the runtime. After the distribution, actually, runtime will use controllers to deploy all the network services and use VIM, a multi-VIM project to finish all the lifecycle management. So that's how it works. And for VMware, actually, we focus on the number one. Actually, we contribute to the multi-VIM. We incubate this project and now already make it as a MVP project of ONAP. And there are many memberships already start to contribute their products. And we are targeting to deliver the Beijing release this week. And based on this project, actually, we have another module very important is VNF onboarding. where we targeted to resolve one problem is how to detect and make the, you know, the descriptions of virtual functions can be compliant with the underlying infrastructure. Instead of you deploy it, then you find, oh no, it doesn't work. So it's too late, right? So we will contribute to the constraint detection function of a layer. And then we will do the, you know, at runtime, do the DCAE. That means contribute the telemetry and infrastructure events, you know, federation functions to help the closed loop resilience. That's, you know, the main topic I will deliver later. So here is a use case we deployed in ONAP and Multibeam. And from left to right, you can see a different, you know, sequence of the connection of different cloud airlines. You can see on the UE side, that's just user devices, and they will go through some transport zone. That's run side, you know, connections. They will go through the MEC. That's a mobile edge cloud, where you can do the initial, you know, processing, just some limited, you know, and latency aware, you know, processing over there. And then use some, you know, fiber connection or, you know, high throughput, you know, connection between the MEC and edge cloud. You can see we will have a higher aggregation point cloud. That's edge cloud. And where we will deploy some, you know, data plane of the some, you know, virtual functions, such as, you know, here I mentioned some, you know, SP gateway or something like that. And where actually, we just considering the latency and the throughput, we're trying to deploy some, you know, part of the data plane functions onto the edge cloud to avoid, you know, the transport backward cost. And then we will deploy all the control plane on the core cloud, because that's very rich at the, you know, all the capabilities. So where we can do the, you know, all the aggregation and high-speed computing, all these things. And between the edge and the core cloud, actually we will use MPLS, SPTN, and WAN technology to connect with each other. And of course, we need to manage all the SDN, you know, gateway between each other. And for the core cloud, we need to consider some high availability scenario. That means maybe the user, you know, want to expand their cloud from core cloud to public cloud for the more capacity or something like that. Actually, they can just scale out their workload to the, you know, public cloud, such as Azure or AWS here. And the other thing is about, you know, disaster recovery. That means if the data center have some disasters and all the key or core virtual functions will be transmitted or migrated to the, you know, enterprise other, you know, backend. So that's the whole, you know, different kind of cloud. And let's propose some requirement to the Veeam side. That means we need to support a different kind of cloud. That's edge and core and public and private and bare metal and virtual box, such as MEC. It's often, you know, bare metal things. And we need to cover all the management of the virtual functions. That's NFV and SDN side. So that's a high challenge for the multi-VM side. So in this platform, actually, we propose this. You know, in multi-VM, we realize such kind of functions. We provide a unified northbound interface, and we just plug into the different cloud backend into our framework. We can manage different kind of cloud at the same time. That means we can support a different version of OpenStack at the same time, such as in China Mobile's OpenLab, we support Kilo and Okata at the same time. And we support the connection across different cloud, as I mentioned. And the most important thing, actually, you know, no matter it's container, it's VM, or, you know, migration scenarios, that's a different layer of resource we can handle through multi-VM. And we can, you know, prepare all the resource pool from the very beginning, such as how to cook the, you know, resource pool ready for the ONAP usage. That's actually log into the scope of the multi-VM. So, and think about, you know, future. Actually, a little bit, you know, next release, actually, we will do the 5G, you know, deployment. And actually, this is just give some, you know, more concept about what we want to do about network slicing and how to use multi-vim to evolve all the, you know, delivers to the next generation. You can see here a network slice actually is a set of network services with a clear definition about SLA and operational policies. And actually, from the underlay perspective, you can see a network slice consists of a bunch of PNF or VNF together. And all the VNF and the PNF, CNF are running on a shared infrastructure. That means shared with other network slices. And even for a customer, actually, they can buy several network slices, such as one for the EMBB, that's enterprise broadband, you know, the service, and the other for the common, you know, for the mobile service. The other, you can see they can use different slices to, you know, for the different SLA guarantee. But the key, you know, requirement here is a zero interference between different slices. That means no matter the infrastructure is shared, no matter all the CNF, VNF running over there is shared among different you know, slices, but we need to keep the isolation of the traffic of different slices. So actually, multi-vim is supposed to use, you know, underlying infrastructure technology such as, you know, adaptive routing and traffic management to handle this, you know, isolation things. So that's all the background, and let us see what we did in the multi-vim project. And you can see we provide a unified northbound interface and specific southbound interface. The south interface is used to plug into different cloud backend, such as here we show we have Azure, we have Wind River, and we have VMware. Different kind of, you know, backends can use a plug-in, you know, interface into, and all the functions will be exposed into the consistent way through the northbound interface. And what kind of functions we support nowadays? The first one is about registry and unregistry. Because it doesn't matter, as I mentioned, it's a basic cloud infrastructure or OpenStack clusters or some, you know, Kubernetes clusters or something, you know, manages the OpenStack or Kubernetes clusters can be registered to multi-vim today. And then we will use a catalog and eventually to manage everything. And we expose the FCAPS management. Actually, the closed loop functions belong to layer. You know, we will provide the plugin functions to collaborate with different kind of monitors. And then we will provide the image, you know, copy and the distribution functions. That means, you know, across different cloud island after the service onboarding and the distribution, actually all the image will upload to the multi-vim. But if the people want to deploy, you know, the service into different cloud, that means we need to distribute the cloud. That means copy from the store, the DB, okay, from to the target, you know, cloud. So that's what image copy and distribution did. And then we, of course, doing the basic lifecycle management. That's about VM or any resource unit, create, delete, or something like that. And lastly, but also very importantly, we keep everything very thin and very customizable by a declarative language defined template. That means use YAML or JSON, actually you can, you know, describe, use a declarative language to describe the basic interface input and output. Everything automatically, no stop of the, you know, nowadays multi-vim, the REST API will be exposed right now. So that's very convenient for any people want to expose some, you know, specific functions to their backend. So that's basically, you know, the functions of multi-vim. And the app layer, you can see there are some consumer modules from ONAP. That's about some, you know, consumer services such as data collection and analysis engine. And we have the VNF validation functions, as I mentioned, want to use the image, you know, and the infrastructure constraints detection and validation functions, and also others. All the ONAP actually provide a service discover mechanism, because everything in ONAP will be published as microservices. ONAP provide a framework to, you know, let all the services automatically, you know, discovered whenever, you know, at runtime. So that's the whole loop we provide through this project. And then I will give more introduction about the closed loop, you know, process. Actually, that's an overview. You can see, okay, there are several phases. On the left side, we need to collect faults and events and notifications from a different layer. That can be virtual infrastructure layer. It can be virtual function layer. And actually, we have a network service layer, right? And we can correlate them together as a step two. And then we will use some policy to guide how to recover if anything happens. And lastly, we will execute this, you know, recovery action. So that's a sequence, you know, how to do the closed loop resilience. That's the first step. Actually, we will leverage EMS, that's element management service in the telco world. We will use it to collect all the VNF layer fault. And then we will use VMware Ops to collect all the virtual infrastructure layer. That's include the fault or event or notification. You know, the three things actually are totally different in this, you know, in this monitoring world. And then we can jump to the second phase where we need to correlate. That means we need to root cause. Maybe there are always, you know, something happening in the underlying, but the whole network just down. Or something happening in virtual network function itself instead of, you know, some, you know, other alerts happening in the infrastructure. So here we need to correlate them to find out the root cause, where actually we can leverage some, you know, analysis or AI technologies to understand what happened and log, you know, all these things together to give the reason. And then actually we will go to the policy map trigger healing. That means we will use a policy actually. Policy is actually it's an intelligence file. It also should be, you know, upload. When you upload your virtual function packages, actually you can write a policy, you know, file together with that package. And after that, you know, with you, virtual network descriptors are passed, actually all the things also passed to the policy engine. And the policy engine will identify, you know, the condition, the correspondence between, you know, the condition of the fault happened and what kind of action should, you know, heal this kind of case. After that, actually, we will go to the heal. That means already guided by the policy, what will be do, what will be done in, you know, whenever anything happens. They will call the multi-beam or other modules, because not only, maybe, you know, it's infrastructure error or it's not. So if it is an infrastructure error, multi-beam will be called to recover this, you know, error modules. And so that's here, we provide a product named as vSphere Integrated OpenStack. So we will use OpenStack technology to recover everything. So that's how the closed loop policy works. You can see that's the sequence of workflow, how, you know, nowadays ONAP works. You can see, as I mentioned, if anything happened, you know, all the events will you know, send to the DMAP, that's a message bus of the ONAP, and then the DCAE, that's analysis engine, will analyze everything and call the homers to do the correlation of the alert, and then they will call the policy to see, okay, if this case happened, what will do next? And then the, you know, the control will to the controller, and the controller will call the multi-cloud to do the recovery things. So that's a complete closed loop. But what we want to do is now this way. If we find, you know, the root cause is happening in the infrastructure layer, actually we do not need to, you know, emit all these things to the app layer and go through a long loop to find, okay, that's the multi-vim can handle things. So we want to add here, you know, we already add a policy to judge if anything happened here, we will just use multi-vim to heal everything. The precondition here is we know the error is caused by infrastructure and the irrelevant, total irrelevant to the, you know, virtual functions itself. So this is a, you know, architecture we used. Here you can see we still use the southbound, you know, plug-in technology to allow different monitors to plug into, such as we realize operation manager. Actually, here is just, you know, example, because we come from VMware, it's more easier for us to leverage such kind of products. But actually, you can use a Celometer or other, you know, OpenStack technology, but leverage the same framework to plug into the events and the faults and all the detections into the ONAP system. And then if anything happens, actually, the multi-vim will, you know, through a northbound interface to drop all the, or emit all the messages to the ONAP message bus, and where actually the analysis engine will consume and catch, you know, all the, you know, alerts things and do the closed loop judge. And here is a recover, how to do the recover. For example, you know, FC is one kind of controller in the ONAP world. Actually, here is the first step is whenever, you know, VROps find something wrong with the infrastructure layer, it will throw out the error to the message bus. And the ONAP message bus will, you know, the app controller will listening to this message bus and then trigger the multi-vim to do the recover. And the multi-vim plugin, you know, actually will, you know, do the federation things. That means collect all the OpenStack layered events, such as NOAA, Neutron, all these events, and then do the, you know, reaction, recover action properly. You know, nowadays, actually, original way is, you know, FC, for example, they already decide, okay, something happened in the infrastructure layer. Maybe a target action is to restart a VM. That's a very simple, you know, you know, resilience loop. But what they will do is keep loop, you know, just use while, you know, loop to listening, to ping, actually ping the target VM. And until it is totally powered on, and they will start the VM again. So that's how, you know, FC did today. But actually what we introduced this work is we already, you know, emit all the OpenStack and, you know, infrastructure events. That's two kinds, right? One kind is about VROps emit the, all, the faults and alerts from the infrastructure layer. The other part is, you know, we can emit all the NOAA, Neutron, all these, you know, OpenStack events to the message bus of ONAP. So the ONAP consumer, you know, modules can listen to such kind of events and trigger the recover, you know, promptly. So that's what we did for the, you know, closed loop optimization. So after this adoption of the work, you can see that's we have do some basic performance improvement. The left side is elapsed time. That means start from the you know, restart process until to everything done, you know, with the process. And we use elapsed time as a matrix to compare the two technologies, and we found over 80% you know, improvement. And the other metrics here is about CPU utilization. Because the original way without the event federation functions, they trying to use loop to ping and keep listening all these things. So that will consume more CPU. But if you change into the, you know, event federation based, you know, way, it's save a lot of CPU. So that's a just a very small, you know, but already obvious about the result. So I will show some demo about the hosting I just introduced. In the demo, I will show several steps. The first one is I will let you see the basic, you know, web firewall deployment through ONAP, and how to do the basic, you know, closed loop in ONAP. That's just some background in the demo. And then I will enable the controller to adopt a new technology. That means based on the event-driven things to do the recover. And then we can, you know, simulate some error and use the VROps to catch the, you know, the error things and trigger the whole policy guide closed loop things. You will see how to recover one network service. So that's a demo. Let me show. Should be this one. Let me see. Oh, yes. Okay. Sorry about that. Okay, so let's start. Here is actually the already, you know, WayFirewall already deployed by ONAP. And here we needed to use two scripts to connect the WayFirewall instance with the A and the AI, you know, inventory instance, because lets the, you know, the FC controller to know how to map into the different, you know, VM underlying. Because this is a demo, so we try to use this, you know, scripts to give some shortcut show. And you know, actually there were two instances. One is about the you know, the generator of the packages. The other one is the WayFirewall functions, so we need to connect them too. And this is the VIO, you know, page. Actually, Horizon, you can see the VM ID is totally mapped here with an input to do the, you know, bridge. And also WayFirewall actually is deployed by HIT in MultiVim. Of course, it is called by the orchestrator of the ONAP. And then you can see that's the second one, you know, that's about the sync things we will connect them to. After this script, actually in the inventory service, you will search. You can find which instance and what's the VM ID, you know, for the WayFirewall instance. And then actually we will do the basic policy things. As I mentioned, policy is very important to you know, map the precondition to the recover action. Here actually we will stop the original policy and re-enable the new policy, as I just introduced. Then everything is okay, so now ready, we can show the recovery action. Yes, that's a new policy already be restarted. And everything, you know, it's a microservice, so restart the instance will make everything, you know, work. And actually in the policy, we have a module inside is HOMOS that's doing the, you know, correlation of different alerts from different layers. Okay, so that's how the new policy works. And here is you know, something from the, you know, postman. Actually, I want you show to see, you know, a totally correspondence between the VM, you know, and what your network functions. That's just, you know, the inventory already updated by the scripts I just showed. Okay. So here you can see the mapped IP. You know, we can get the, you know, the target VM IP by the IPC. That's a controller of ONAP. Yeah. Yeah. That's actually just, you know, all the things updated in the IPC. That means, you know, IPC already gets all the inventory services, as you can see here. That's all the packages, you know, on the DMAP, that's message bus of ONAP. And all this, you know, after the scripts, everything already work, and you can collect all the data from message bus. That's just the get to let everyone know what happens in the message bus. And actually, after that, you can see, okay, the, you know, the throughput becomes, you know, down to the and the, you know, just be limited by the IPC. That's one kind of, you know, closed loop can do by the ONAP. Actually, we will do another thing. That means, you know, instead of you tune the UDP, you know, how many packages will be sent out to the web firewall, we can just trigger the new recovery loop. By, you know, actually here, the simulation is just to trigger OS panic in one, you know, VM. And then we can see the VROps will collect all the informations and errors in the infrastructure and then trigger the proper recovery. Yes, here we will use the scripts to, you know, trigger the event federation-based recover functions instead of the original, you know, the throughput control functions. Yeah, this is a target VM. Actually, we will log into the VM to trigger the OS panic. Here is a, you know, screenshot of the VROps, where you can see everything before the trigger, everything is normal. And then we will do the OS panic trigger. Yes, here already triggered. And then let us see what happened in the IPC controller. The way we show what happened is the C log, track the log, you know, to see what happened over there. Let us to, you know, to read the log of IPC controller. A little bit slow, sorry. Because I didn't, you know, process anything of the demo. We're just doing, you know, doing the work and at the same time record everything. So let us see what happened in the controller. Here is a, you know, echo command to trigger the OS panic and let us see if anything happened in the log. Okay, I know. Then we run up the, you know, VROps listener. VROps listener will monitor to get all the alerts. Oh, I jumped too fast. I'm sorry. Actually, I need several minutes to finish this demo. Thank you. We will finish everything, in 1 minute. Yeah, this is a log. That means VROps already sent an image to the DMAP. Actually, you can see VROps already found this right now, already found the error. And then in the log, you will see what is happening, accordingly based on this event. Actually, you will see, let the log see, you can see all the things will happen. Firstly, they will stop this VM and listen to the NOVA event. After the VM is already, completely power off, they will trigger a restart. So that's how the log shows, and that's actually what we did in the controller. So that's a basic thing we contribute to this. So in this work, actually, what we did is collaborate the events and faults across different layers from the underlying OpenStack to the ONAP message bus. So that's the work show today. Thank you for your participation to this presentation. Thank you.